She seems to be calm now, so I think we should be okay. So first up is a very well-known movie, which is still in the packaging, which I'm not sure why, but it's The Notebook with Ryan Gosling and Rachel McAdams, and James Marsden. Sort of thing. It's a good movie. Okay, next. This is my, I don't know if I ever told you guys this, but this is my favorite movie, pretty much of all time. It is She's the Man with Amanda Bynes and Channing Tatum. Proves that girls can do anything guys can do in She's the Man. The laughs are non-stop when Viola, disguised as her twin brother Sebastian, joins the high school boys soccer team and helps win the big game while unexpectedly falling for Duke. The hot star forward, Viola discovers that dealing with high school politics and twisted love triangles is a major challenge much when you're a guy who's really a girl. She's the Man features an ensemble cast of up-and-coming stars and hit songs, so kick back and get ready to laugh out loud. I kind of want to watch this movie now. I might watch it later today. We'll see. This is the movie that made me fall in love with Channing Tatum. Okay. Moving on. This is more my mom's movie, but I like it too. This is Diane Lane's Under the Tuscan Sun. Studio that brought you Sweet Home Alabama comes the extraordinary romantic comedy starring Academy Award nominee Diane Lane, based on the number one New York Times best-selling book Under the Tuscan Sun. Follows San Francisco writer Frances Mays to Italy as a good friend offers her a special gift: 10 days in Tuscany. Once there, she is captivated by its beauty and warmth, impulsively buys an aging but very charming villa. Fully embracing new friends and local color, she finds herself immersed in a life-changing adventure filled with enough unexpected surprises, laughter, friendship, and romance to restore her new home and her belief in second chances. So it's basically like the story of her starting over. Offers you 1,000 chances. All you have to do is take one. I'm only on the third movie. I should hurry up. Okay. Superman Returns. I'm not big into superhero movies, but this one's good. He's back, a hero for our millennium, and not a moment too soon, because during the 5 years Superman sought his home planet, things changed on his adopted planet. Nations moved on without him. Lois Lane now has a son, a fiancé, and a Pulitzer for Why the World Doesn't Need Superman. And Lex Luthor has a plan that will destroy millions, no billions, of lives. Filmmaker Bryan Singer gives the world the Superman it needs, honoring the legend everyone loves while taking it in a powerful new direction. Brandon Routh proves a perfect choice to wear the hero's cape, leading a top cast that includes Kate Bosworth as Lois and Kevin Spacey as Lex. And the thrills from a sky grapple with a tumbling jumbo jet to a continent convulsing showdown redefine wow. I'm always around, Superman tells Lois. You'll be glad he is. And I love this guy. He is in the show Arrow and The Flash. And he's pretty cool. Next movie is Facing the Giants. I have all this packaging on here, I don't know why. But this movie is pretty old-ish. Part of the synopsis is covered, so let me see what I can. I think it says, in his 6 years of coaching football, Coach Grant never left his something winning season. When faced with seemingly insurmountable professional and personal crises, the idea of giving up has never come easier. It's only after an unexpected visitor challenges him to trust in the power of faith that he discovers the strength to persevere. So, fictional movie. Sister Tess captures the heart of Jane's boss, with whom she's secretly in love, inspiring Jane to change her always a bridesmaid destiny. Again, another predictable one, but she's funny. She's like goofy yet serious in all her roles, if that makes sense. I think she's enjoyable. Song. Circus Ride with Martin Lawrence and Raven Simone in Disney's chaotic comedy College Road Trip. Ambitious and confident Melanie Porter is eagerly looking forward to her first big step towards independence, a girl's only road trip to check out colleges. But this rite of passage takes a wrong turn when her overprotective father insists on escorting her instead, and Melanie's dream trip quickly turns into a nightmare of wild and wacky curves. So fasten your seatbelts for a non-stop, laugh-out-loud, madcap adventure that'll drive you silly. This is itchy. And this is the first musical that I'm gonna show you. It's Mamma Mia with Meryl Streep and Colin Firth and Amanda Seyfried, I think her name is. And it has all of the old ABBA songs and everything like that. It's a good movie. Sophie has just one wish to make her wedding perfect, to have her father walk her down the aisle. Now she just has to find out who he is. Join the music, laughter, and fun of the irresistibly charming Mamma Mia, the movie. Academy Award winner Meryl Streep leads an all-star cast, including Pierce Brosnan and Colin Firth, as well as up-and-comers Amanda Seyfried and Dominic Cooper. This musical celebration of mothers, daughters, and fathers, and true loves lost and new ones found. Based on the Broadway smash hit and filled with the ABBA songs you know and love, it's the feel-good experience that will have you singing and dancing over and over again. I've never seen the Broadway play. Here's another one. The Phantom of the Opera, which was, I think, one of Gerard Butler's first movies. And he's amazing. He has a really nice voice. He is a genius whose rapturous music fills the opera populaire of 1870 Paris, and a solitary soul hiding his disfigurement behind a mask and dwelling in the catacombs below. But he can no longer hide his love for young soprano Christine, and the phantom may emerge from the shadows past the point of no return. The strange musical sensation magically and hauntingly comes to the screen in director Joel Schumacher's lavish production, sweeping audiences aloft to new cinematic heights of sight and sound grandeur. Gerard Butler, Emmy Rossum, and Patrick Wilson play the fateful love triangle that unfurls in splendor, suspense, and in the music of the night. Tyler Perry's Why Did I Get Married? And there is also, this movie. At a secluded cabin in the snow-capped mountains of Colorado, eight married college friends have gathered for their annual seven-day reunion. But the cozy mood is altered when one of the husbands show up with a sexy young temptress in tow. As dirty laundry is aired, each couple wonders about the strength of their own marriage. The husbands and wives take an intimate look at lives while struggling with issues of temptation, infidelity, and forgiveness as they seek a way forward. That description made it seem like they're all really bad people. They're not. And there's some comedy mixed in there as well. Swank and Gerard Butler, P.S. I Love You is your very own message full of fun, love, triumph, and romance. Okay. Now, a lot of these you may know, so I'm not going to read the description. We'll see. Like this one, I probably won't. But it is Mulan. If you didn't know, there's a second part to Mulan, which is one of my favorite Disney movies. This is basically about their marriage and the obstacles that they face in getting there. There's Mushu. He's one of the best parts of the whole movie. Of sense of wit and whimsy, Matilda is a great comedy with a great message. The adults laugh as much, if not more, than the kids. This is the evil principal. Her name is Miss Trunchbull, and she's terrifying. I was afraid of her as a child. This isn't a movie, but obsessed I was with the Jonas Brothers when I was in middle school. And I still love him, this one, Nick Jonas. So this is just like an extended movie of one of their tours, I think. Behind the scenes stuff, and I got this as a gift one year because everyone knew how obsessed I was with them. And I'm not ashamed. Viola does everything she can to break up the happy couple. But when Charlie gets wise to her schemes and decides to fight back, a wild and hysterical battle of wits begins. So he goes away on business, I think, for a while. And so they're alone together, and she's living in their house. And they just go back and forth at each other. It's not overly funny, but it's funny. And one of my favorite musicals of all time is Hairspray. I went to see this movie in theaters with my cousin, my aunt, and my mom when it first came out, which was years ago. I don't remember what year, but it was a while ago. It wasn't supposed to be funny, but it was so funny. John Travolta plays the mother, and so he has like a big suit on, and they dress him up as a woman, and it's hysterical. And it's meant to be an overly cheesy movie, and it's great. And I became obsessed with it when I was younger, so I bought the soundtrack and everything. To all the songs. There is no synopsis, but there are just reviews on the back. It says, two big thumbs up, arousing and rambunctious movie spectacle. I can't speak today. I'm sorry. An explosion of talent, energy, and fun. Going on. one of the cheesiest movies ever, but I like it. As you can tell, I like cheesy movies. It says in the back, Hilary Duff stars as Terry, a small town girl with the voice of a big time singer. Following her dreams, she heads to Los Angeles for the summer at a famous music school. Life in the big city is full of surprises, but with the help of some super cool friends, an encouraging teacher, and a super cute boy, this all-American girl is set to have the time of her life. The stars will shine brightly as she sings her heart out for the whole world to hear. See, even the description is cheesy. Await you in Willy Wonka's factory. Explore fields of soft, minty sugar grass in the chocolate room. Sail along the chocolate river in a pink sugar boat. Experiment with everlasting gobstoppers in the inventing room. Observe talented squirrels in the nut room and travel to the television room by a glass elevator. You'll find a lot that's funny, a lot that's mysterious, adventure as sweet and satisfying as a Wonka whipple-scrumptious fudge mellow delight bar. This dazzling film, adapted from Roald Dahl's classic children's novel, directed by Tim Burton and starring Johnny Depp and Freddie Highmore, is your golden ticket to a world so inventive, so imaginative, you won't want to miss a delicious moment. By far my favorite musical of all time, and this West Side Story, and I know every line, I know every lyric. It's really bad, but I love it so much. It says, this brilliant film sets the ageless story of Romeo and Juliet against a backdrop of gang warfare in 1950s New York. Directed by Robert Wise and Jerome Robbins, and scripted by Ernest Lehman, the film combines Leonard Bernstein and Stephen Sondheim's unforgettable score with Robbins' own exuberant choreography to achieve an exhilarating work of art. It's a Romeo and Juliet story against the Italians and the Puerto Ricans of that time. My dog is walking around. I'm sorry. Okay, we're almost done. I think we have two more. Walt Disney's The Game Plan with The Rock and Madison Bates when she was a little girl. And it says, in this hilarious and heartwarming family comedy, one of sports' toughest players ever takes on his biggest challenge yet, fatherhood. A superstar with an ego bigger than a football field, Joe Kingman is getting ready for a run at the big championship game when the 8-year-old daughter he never knew existed shows up at his not-so-family-friendly bachelor pad. As the big game gets closer, he begins to realize the most meaningful win he can achieve is the heart of the one little fan who counts the most. It is a heartwarming story, and he falls Let's start.